In this tutorial, we are going to start with a new topic, that is database management database management access 2016. Okay, so these features are mainly available in the access 2016 under the Microsoft Office package. Okay, so database management access 2016. So in this chapter, the following people maintains at records at different places. How do they maintain records? Like teacher in a school, doctor at a clinic hospital, and an employee at a general store. So these are the places where a database mainly used. A hospital, a store, a school. So in these places the databases are used. Okay. So here, database and its components. So you will learn about the database and its components, DBMS and its functions. Starting access 2016, creating databases, entering data in the table, data types, and setting the primary key. So these functions you will mainly learn in this MS Access. Okay, so you will learn how to set queries. So mainly in this Access 2016, everything mainly is automatic. You don't have to write any queries, just you have to select the options and you will get the outputs. Okay. So your school is starting a reading club. You are appointed as in charge of the club. You have the responsibility to encourage the students to learn and also to maintain a record of books they have read. So in this place, what we can use a database. Now the introduction. So when data are processed, you get relevant information. If you observe carefully, you will find that all organizations maintain data depending on their needs. So each and every organization maintains a database. For example, a school maintains data about teachers, students, academic excellence, books, sports. So these are the different fields where the databases are used. A database helps you organize the collected data in a tabular format. So tabular format means in a table. Okay, so database is a collection also. If you are asked what do you mean by define a database, then you can write this. A database helps you organize the collected data in tabular format. Or you can also write a database is a place where we can store the data or related data. So it allows you to enter, access and analyze the data. It also helps you to retrieve the required information easily. Therefore, the data in the database should be updated regularly. So since we can access the data get the update from the database, so therefore we need to regularly update the database. Okay, so here is the activity one. So think of more examples where data are maintained and organized. One example is shared with you, contacts in your on mobile phone. So here where your data is maintained. Okay, so you can here write some more points where the data is maintained. Okay, so in the next tutorial we will learn about the components of database. Thank you.